Hi everyone, welcome back to Tech Booth. Today we are talking optical sync mode, a way of triggering your speed lights using the light that comes from other speed lights or even your inbuilt flash on your camera. All you have to do to get optical sync working is to go into the menu of your speed light and find where you can set your speed light to S1 or S2. Those stand for slave 1 and slave 2. So let us set the TT600 and the Young Noor 560 to optical sync mode. For you to get into the optical sync mode on the Godox TT600, just go to the second button that's written Zoom and FN for function. Long press it until you get this menu, and then use the set button to cycle through the different functions that you can adjust until you get to the one that's written OS. And you can now use the dial to change between S1, S2, and off. On the Young Noor 560, all you need to do is to go to the third button that has the lightning and Wi-Fi sign and just cycle through by pressing between manual, TX, RX, and then you go into your optical sync modes, S1 and S2. When you set your speed light to S1, as soon as it sees another flash go off, it will also go off in sync with that other flash. Let me take this really simple one, flip the flash up, and then when I take a picture and the flash goes off, this one also goes off. Hope you can see that. This flash and this one go off in sync with each other. So that's S1 mode. As soon as it sees a flash go off, it will trigger this speed light. And it doesn't matter which camera you're using. It can be this inbuilt flash or this old point and shoot. If I power it on and I take a picture, let's see, there we go. See, as soon as it sees this go off, the speed light also goes off. So that is slave 1 or sync 1, S1 on your speed light. Now, if you have a more advanced camera like this one, again, it has the option for a built-in flash. When you go into the menu, you can set this flash to what is called TTL. Now, TTL stands for through the lens. And what that means is the flash is also used for metering the scene to gauge how much flash power is needed to get a good exposure. So when you're in TTL mode, it is the automatic mode for your flash unit. You can set TTL on your built-in flash, or if you have this on top and you're using this as your master flash, you can also set your speed light to TTL. Now with this Godox TT600, it's a manual only flash. It doesn't have TTL, but the built-in flash on this camera actually has TTL. So we go into the menu and we set it to TTL. And when you set your master flash like this one to TTL, it means you want to use it in the scene as part of your lighting. You need to now change your speed light to S2 or slave 2. Now, why would you want to set this to S2? Well, it has to do with how TTL works. When you are in TTL mode and you take a picture, there are two flashes that fire consecutively. The first one is used to meter the scene. And what that means is the camera is trying to figure out how much flash power is needed for that scene. And once it has calculated the flash power needed, it then goes off a second time with the right amount of flash to give you a good exposure. So your flash actually goes off twice. And let me try and demonstrate. I hope you can see it. So when you take a picture, you can see it goes off twice. Now, if we are in S1, the speed light will go off the very first time this flashes. But you don't want that because that first flash is not used in taking your picture. The second flash is the one that is used in taking the picture. So you want that second flash to be in sync with your speed light. And so in S2 mode, the speed light ignores that first flash that is used to evaluate the lighting. It then goes off the second time when the main flash goes off and you're taking the picture, and both are now in sync and you have the lighting that you require. So S1 you're using when you're using manual only flash, and the flash goes off only once and it goes off immediately it sees the first flash. In S2 you use S2 when you have set your internal flash or whatever flash you're using as your master on your camera to TTL or through the lens, so that it ignores that first flash that is used to meter out the scene and then goes off when the master flash goes off. What are some of the advantages and disadvantages of using optical sync in your photography? The first one, obviously, is very simple. You don't need any additional equipment. So if you want to start out learning how to use off-camera flash, this is a good place to start, because you don't need to buy anything else except the speed light that you have. And if you have an inbuilt flash on your camera, that is all you need. The second advantage of the optical sync mode is that you can mix and match different makes and models of units. As long as they have the optical sync option, you can set them to the optical sync mode that you want to use, and you are able to trigger them without any problem. The optical sync mode also provides a backup if your triggers fail for some reason and you are desperate. You can use the optical sync mode as your backup trigger. Optical sync has its limitations. For example, if you're working in bright sunlight, you may not get consistent results in triggering your speed lights, because obviously the sensor will get a bit confused with the bright sunlight, and the flash unit, it might not be able to see it properly. So working in bright sunlight will not give you consistent results. One of the other disadvantages is that you can't use this over a great distance. Obviously, the distance will depend on what you are using as your master flash, how strong it is. The other disadvantage is that for optical sync to work, you need to have a line of sight between the sensor that is here and whatever you are using as your master flash. The other disadvantage of using optical sync is that you're not able to control flash power using the master flash. You have to go to the flash that is being triggered and adjust all your settings manually. And that's it for today, a very simple way of triggering off-camera speed lights, the optical sync mode. See you next time on Tech Booth.